Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my channel. If you want to see the upcoming tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 18th episode about SharePoint Modern Site. In this episode, we'll add custom CSS and JavaScript using App Customizer. Before adding App Customizer, we need to make sure we got all necessary tools installed on our machine. So in new tab, search SPFX Human Generator. Open the first link. Click Get Started and set up development environment. If you scroll down, the first thing we need is Node.js. If this is not installed on your machine, you can click on this link. You can then download Node.js and install them on your machine. If you scroll down again, we then need a code editor. For this tutorial, I'm using Visual Studio Code. Then we need Gulp. If you want to install Gulp, you can use this command line. Then we need Yeoman. And again, if you want to install Yeoman, you can use this command line. Finally, we need SharePoint Generator. If you want to install SharePoint Generator, then you can use this command line. If you want to install all these three in one go, if you scroll slightly above, you can copy and run this command line, which help you to install Gulp, Yeoman, and SharePoint Generator. Once all the tools are installed, click Extension, Getting Started, and build your first Application Customizer extension. Scroll down and copy this command line. Make sure you create a project folder. In my case, I have created custom style and script. Then open your text editor and open your project over here. Click View and Terminal. Make sure you choose PowerShell over here, because if you choose other, sometimes it might not work as expected. Paste the command line and hit Enter key. Add the solution name. For now, custom style and script is okay, so just hit Enter key. Choose Extension, Application Customizer. Add the Application Customizer name. I will say Custom Style and Script. Now, this will take some time depending on your machine. So, let's wait for the time being. To run the project, type gulp serve and hit enter key. It will then try to open the project in a browser. You might also see some issue over here, but that's fine. You can open your text editor. Copy this query string, go back to the home site, and at the end of the URL, paste the query string and hit Enter key. click Load Debug Script. And now you are in debug mode, means whatever change you make in the code, you can see a preview over here. We are using Application Customizer for this project. So in order to see the changes at the beginning, we have to build the project. It will generate a package for us, and that package needs to be uploaded in App Catalog. We will do them later, but for now, let's create CSS file. Let's try to add some style. So in this heading, I want to add red color. So copy the parent class name, control zone, and the span role heading, I want to add a red color like this. So copy the style and paste them over here. Save the style. I will save in desktop saying custom style.css. Then create a JavaScript file. Let's add some JavaScript. I will just add alert. This works. Again, save the JavaScript file. I will say custom.js.js. Now open src folder, extension, and open this application customizer.ts file. Over here, we have to import SP component loader from Microsoft. Then at the bottom, we have to load CSS and load script. Inside this code, we have to add the path to the CSS and a JavaScript. Now, let's add custom style and custom JavaScript inside site assets of this home site. So, open the home site, click Cog menu, site content, click site assets. And over here, let's add custom style and custom JS. Now, copy this part and add over here. For CSS, it's custom style.css. And for JavaScript, it's custom.js.js. When I open home site, you might notice there was an alert message. It was coming from this line of code. Feel free to remove them if you don't want it. Now, it's time to build the project. So in terminal, press Ctrl+C. Then type gulp package.solution --zip. Once this is done, it will generate a package for us, and you will find the package in our project folder, SharePoint, and solution. You have to add this package in the app catalog. So to open the app catalog, you have to click on the app launcher, then click on admin, on the left hand side click show all and SharePoint. Click More Features and click Open button under Apps. So in this app catalog, we have to drag and drop the package. If you want to add them to all site, make sure this is chosen and click enable app. Click close. You should see a green icon once it is enabled. Now, if you open the home site, you should see both JavaScript and CSS is working. Let's try to make some changes on CSS and JavaScript. So in CSS, instead of red color, I want to add green color. And in JavaScript, I'll just add this works again. After making these changes, don't forget to re-upload them in our site assets. So let's go back to desktop and let's re-upload custom style and custom JS. Go back to the home site and do hard refresh. And we can see JavaScript is updated and the CSS is updated as well. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll create SPFX web part and get some API data. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you and see you soon.